Today in this session, we are going to discuss about conversion of PDA to CFG. In the last session, we have seen the conversion of CFG to PDA, and now we are going to see the reverse of that, conversion of a PDA to CFG. Conversion of PDA in the sense that here's transition functions will be given, we need to convert it to CFG based upon the algorithm. See here, for example, this is the PDA given with transition rules. In this, we need to identify what is the push operation, pop operation and skip operation. So based upon this operation, there are different steps which we need to follow. First, let us see the algorithm, how to convert it. So how to convert a given PDA to CFG. So in order to convert this, the input will be a PDA and the output will be a CFG. So first step is, the predictions for the start symbol S are given by, so the predictions we need to write in this manner for the start symbol. So S produces Q naught Z naught Q for each state Q in capital Q. So each state Q in the sense in PDA, if we see here, if we observe, the states here are Q naught and Q1. So for these Q naught and Q1 state, we need to write, we have to use this Q naught and Q1 states over here. So once we have to consider Q naught state, and the other time we need to consider Q1 state. So that is the reason here Q in the sense the states present in the set capital Q. So state Q in capital Q, that is Q belongs to capital Q. And the second step is, for each move that pops a symbol from the stack with the transition as. That means, as I already mentioned you, that in PDA we are having three operations: push operation, pop and skip operation. So if it is a pop operation, then how do we produce a prediction from the transition function? See here, it is the transition function. Here by seeing this epsilon, we can easily identify that it is a pop operation. Yesterday we have seen, in the last previous classes we have seen, that how to design the examples. We have considered few examples how to design the PDA. So in that we have seen, if epsilon is present, then it indicates that pop operation has been done over there. So when there is a pop operation, how do we produce a prediction? See, this is the manner: Q naught, Z naught and Q. Q in the sense, once we are going to write Q naught as per the example which we are going to consider now. Here Q in the sense that the number of states given in the PDA. So those all states we have to consider here. So this is how we are going to write the prediction for the pop operation. Next, for each move that does not pop symbol from stack with transition, for each move in the sense that does not pop means, that does not pop means the opposite of pop operation. What is the opposite of pop operation? Other than pop, push and skip operation. So if it is push and skip operations, we have to follow this step number 3. Delta of Q naught A comma Z naught is equal to Q1 Z1 Z2, this is the transition rule, includes a prediction. So the prediction which we need to write here is Q naught Z naught Q. Here Q in the sense the number of states given in the PDA. So once we are going to write Q naught, for the coming example, once we are going to write Q0 and the other time we are going to write Q1. So, see how to write? A in the sense, see the terminal symbol which is present in this transition function, that terminal symbol we should write here as the output. So, terminal symbol followed by Q1, Z1, Q2. See how we are going to write Q1, Z1, Q2. This part will end with Q2. Again, the next part has to start with Q2. So, Q2, Z2, Q3. Here again the continuation must be started with Q3. Q3, Z3, Q4. Q4, Z4, Q5. Q5, Z5, Q6. Q6, Z6, Q7. In that manner we have to write. So on QM, ZM, Q. For Q, that means Q in the sense all the states which are present in this set capital Q. So, this is how we need to follow the procedure for push and skip operation. So, while taking an example, we can understand in depth. And at the end, after defining all the rules, apply simplification of grammar to get reduced grammar. So, this is the procedure we need to follow. Let us take an example and solve this. This is an example. Give the equivalent CFG for the following PDA. So, this is a PDA given. So, here directly the transition rules are given here. If the transition rule is not given, if the transition diagram is given, it is better to obtain the transition rules first and then solve the example. Then it would become easy to solve the example. So, delta of Q naught be Z naught. Here Z naught is the present top of the stack. Now, see what is the output? Q naught Z, Z naught. In the sense that previous it was Z naught top of the stack. Now, this Z naught has been pushed down and some other is being placed above Z naught. So, that is nothing but here Z. So, that means that push operation has been performed here. Z, Z naught in the sense push operation has been performed. Similarly, if we observe here, if it is epsilon, then it is pop operation. If it is, see here, if again here previous was Z top of the stack and now it is Z, Z in the sense that it is push operation again. And again, if we observe here, previous top of the stack was Z and now the present top of the stack is also Z. That means the top of the stack has not been changed. So, when does the top of the stack doesn't change? During the skip operation. So, this transition will indicate that it is a skip operation. Now, let us see for this. Here if we observe the output is epsilon here, then it indicates the pop operation. So, this indicates the pop operation. And see here, so this indicates the skip operation again. Here Z naught it is and here also it is Z naught. It is not push, it is skip operation. But here, whatever may be, if we observe, there is a separate procedure for pop operation and there is a separate procedure for push and skip operation. So, same procedure for push and skip and the different procedure for pop operation. So, let us see this. the states, we need to write what are the states given in the PDA. The states here are, if we observe, the states are, see what are the states here, Q naught, Q1. Here also Q naught, Q1. So apart from Q naught, Q1, there are no other states present here. So the states here are Q naught and Q1. So stack symbols, what are the stack symbols? Stack symbols in the sense, if we observe, so these will be the stack symbols, the symbols which are pushed into the stack. So they are nothing but, see, Z, Z naught. Here also Z, already we considered Z, Z naught is considered. So the stack symbols here are Z and Z naught. And now we need to write the possible states. So the possible states in the sense, if we observe in the algorithm, S produces Q naught, Z naught, Q. So Q in the sense, once we are going to write Q naught, and the other time we are going to write Q1. So see here, Q naught, Z naught, Q naught. See, first time if we observe here, we are starting with Q naught. Q naught, Z naught, Q naught. And the other one is Q naught, Z naught. So in place of this Q naught, we are writing the other state, that is Q1. Again, if we observe, now we are going to start with Q1, because here we have to consider whatever states are present in the example, we have to write for all these states. Now we are going to start with the other state Q1, Q1, Z0, Q0. So now we have started with Q1, the same process of once we are going to write Q0, and the other time we are going to write Q1. These two terms will remain same if we observe here. Okay. Now see, here we have considered Q naught, Z naught. So apart from Z naught, we are having the other stack symbol, that is Z. Now we need to frame this everything by replacing it with Z. So repeat the same with the other stack symbol Z. See how we are going to write Q naught, Z, Q naught, Q naught, Z, Q1, Q1, Z, Q naught, Q1, Z, Q1. See, this is the procedure. That means what are all these states and stack symbols present in the PDA? We need to write the possibilities with all those stack symbols and states. So this is the first step we are going to write. Now see, the S production is given in rule 1. So S produces Q naught, Z naught, Q naught, Q naught, Z naught, Q1. So in this manner, see how we are going to write this. S produces Q naught, Z naught, Q naught, Q naught, Z naught, Q1. So that is what here in the example, S produces Q naught, Z naught, once we are going to write Q naught, and the other time we are going to write Q1. So this is the start production we have written here. And now we are going to consider each and every transition rule. So the first one is delta of Q B Z naught. So what is the output for this transition function? Q naught Z Z naught. So what is this operation? It is push operation. So for the push operation, we are following this step, step 3. See, if you observe, Q naught Z naught Q produces terminal symbol as output, and this is how we have to write. So whatever state we are ending, the continuation part has to start with the same state which has been ended previously. So see how we are going to write. Delta of Q naught B Z naught is equal to Q naught Z Z naught. See, Q naught Z naught once we are going to write for Q naught, and the other time we are going to write for Q1. And see, produces the terminal symbol in this transition rule is B. So this B will be written here. Q naught, see how it is written. See, here it is Q1. So we have started with Q1. The same if we observe in the example. In the example, it is Q naught. So let's start with Q naught. Q naught Z Q naught. So whatever we have ended, we are going to again start with that only Q naught. Q naught Z Q naught. Once I have written using Z here, and the other time I am going to write with Z naught. Q naught. See. Repeat with this only Q naught, Z naught, Q naught. See, if we observe, whatever has been written here on the LHS part of the production, it has to end with the same on the RHS part of the production. The same processor will be shown in the algorithm also. See here, this is the LHS part of the production. Here Q naught, Z naught, Q. Q in the sense it indicates the number of states in the given PDA. Here in our example we are considering it as Q naught, but here it is not known exactly which state is in the algorithm. So that is why in common it is taken as Q. See here, it consists of Q on the LHS part of the production. At the RHS part of the production, if you observe, it will be ended with the same state which has been written on the LHS part of the production. So that procedure has to be shown in the example also. So that is what we are doing here. Here we have considered Q naught as the state, and at the end it should end up with Q naught on the RHS part of the production. See here, the same if we consider here, once it has ended with Q naught here, but in our example apart from Q naught we are having the other state, that is Q1. So by using the same LHS part of the production, we are going to frame once again Q naught Z naught Q naught. Q naught Z naught Q naught, the terminal symbol as output. Q naught Z, we are considering once as Z. See here, Q naught Z. Here previously we have taken Q naught, and this time we are going to consider the other state, that is Q1, and it has ended with Q1 here. Let us start the remaining part of the production with Q1. So it should start with Q1. See, once we have considered here Z, and the other time we need to consider the other stack symbol Z0. And here if we observe on the LHS of the production, it is Q0. So the complete production on the RHS must end with this Q0. So this is how we have written the production with the state Q naught. Now the same procedure we are going to write for the state Q1. So in place of Q naught, we are just replacing Q1 here. So Q naught Z naught Q1 produces the terminal symbol given in the transition rule B. Q naught C, Q naught Z Q naught. So wherever it has stopped, you have to start with that only Q naught. Once consider Z, and the other time consider Z naught. And here previously it was Q naught on the LHS of the production. So you have ended with Q naught on the RHS part. But now this time we are considering Q1 as the LHS part of the production. Now we have to wind up with Q1 on the RHS part of the production. And similarly, Q naught, Z naught, Q1. See, first time we have taken Q naught. Now we are going to take here as Q1. B, Q naught, Z, Q1. So, wherever it has ended, we need to continue with the same state in the remaining part of the production. That is Q1, Z0. Here the LHS part of the production has ended with Q1. So, now we have to end it with Q1. So, this is how we have to write for the push operation. The same procedure we need to follow for the skip operation also. Now, let us see one example for pop operation. One step for the pop operation. So, delta of Q naught epsilon Z naught is equal to Q naught comma epsilon. So, it is nothing but the pop operation which we have written here also for our identification. Because epsilon is present here. See, if it is a pop operation, let us go to the algorithm. Q naught A Z naught is equal to Q1 comma epsilon. So, Q naught Z naught Q produces A, the terminal symbol. So, now for this scene, here Q naught Z naught Q naught produces, so whatever present here we have written here produces. So, what is the terminal symbol here? Epsilon. So, epsilon is written here. So, this is how we have to write for the pop operation. And see, here we have to include another step also. Q naught Z naught. Once we have considered Q naught and the other time we have to consider the other state given in the PDA Q1 produces epsilon. Because in the algorithm here it is mentioned Q. Q in the sense that the number of states which are considered in the PDA. Here in this PDA the states are Q naught and Q1. So, we need to write once for the Q naught and the other time with Q1. This is how we need to write this step for pop. So, let us see another example, another step for pop operation. So, delta of Q1 B Z is equal to Q1 comma epsilon. So, Q1 Z whatever stack symbol is given here in the transition rule that we need to write. Here actually in the algorithm it is Q, but here Q in the sense once we need to consider Q naught, the other time we need to consider Q1. And what is the terminal symbol here? It is B. So, that will be the output. So, this is the procedure to convert a given PDA to CFG. I hope it is clear and you understood the concept. Thank you.